The Owen James Report is brought to you by...
This program is brought to you by the Grace Kennedy Group. We choose to care. Grace Kennedy Money Services has been here for you and your family, here and abroad, because we understand that you're receiving more than money. You're receiving their love. Grace Kennedy Financial Group has been here for you because we know it's more than just investments, insurance, or banking. It's about security and creating a path to realizing your dreams. For 90 years, honesty, integrity, and trust. The Grace Kennedy Group. We choose to care.
Good evening. This is the Owen James Report. It's a match made in Jamaica. Juicy Beef Limited and Wisinko Beverages have inked a deal in a partnership that will see Juicy and their franchises exclusively selling Wisinko products such as Bigger and Water brands at all outlets. Juicy's CEO, Juki Chin, and Wisinko's managing director, William Mafood, signed the deal this morning.
Two local companies from rural Jamaica, one from St. Catharina, one from Clarendon, you know, have this merger at this time, quite historic. And at a time, it's kind of fitting in that, you know, everybody is promoting, I hear, eat Jamaica, by eat Jamaican, but I don't hear much about drink Jamaican. So today we're gonna say, eat and drink Jamaican.
The deal comes at an opportune time for Wisinko, whose lucrative 15-year deal with Ocean Spray ended recently. Jamaica's gross domestic product growth for the second quarter fell by 20 basis points this year when compared to the corresponding quarter last year. The Statistical Institute says the goods producing and services industries triggered the decrease in second quarter GDP growth year over year. The goods producing sector fell by 0.1% and the services sector fell by 0.2%. In the goods-producing sector, mining and quarrying declined by 10.2%, manufacturing by 1.9%, and construction declined by 3.4%. Transport, storage and communications, real estate, renting and business activities, and government services were mainly responsible for the decline in the services sector. It should be noted that tourism earnings showed growth in this sector in the second quarter. News on the Jamaican market now. It was a day of moderate activity with less than 900,000 shares changing hands. Gains by Carreras, Lime and NCB triggered modest advances in the indices. 19 stocks traded with 7 advancing, 8 declining and 4 holding firm. The winners included Carreras, Jamaica Producers, Lasco Manufacturing, Lime, NCB and Supreme Ventures. The losers included Dolphin Cove, Grace Kennedy, Lasco Financial Services, Scotia Group and Scotia Investments. Now finally, on the foreign exchange market, the benchmark US dollar held firm at an average selling rate of $89.93. However, the Canadian dollar strengthened by 30 cents Jamaican, closing at $91.71. Sterling declined by 12 cents Jamaican to close at an average selling rate of $145.26. And that's the Owen James Report. Good evening.
The Owen James Report was brought to you by Grace
Kennedy. This program was brought to you by the Grace Kennedy Group. We choose to care.